Hey everybody, David here, and today I want to talk about the Arrowverse. If you haven't heard, apparently it's being reported that David Ramsey, who played John Diggle on Arrow for 8 seasons, is now going to be returning to the Arrowverse, but obviously, how can he return if there's no Arrow to return to? Well, thankfully, there's like 6 other shows in the Arrowverse that are still going on, and John Diggle lives. This is awesome news because I love the character of John Diggle. I think he was one of the best, he is the best supporting character on Arrow. So I'm glad that he is going to live on and hopefully be like the Agent Coulson or Nick Fury type character on all these shows, because it would be cool to have some connective tissue going on, especially since we don't know what's going on with the crossover this year. We were told that a Superman and Lois Batwoman crossover was going to be happening, but that was before Ruby Rose left. And then once she left, it was like, is that crossover still a thing, or is what's going on? But it looks like this could be the connective tissue this year. I think they're going to give the crossover a break for now. I have a feeling that's what's going to happen, especially with this pandemic situation, and have John Diggle be the crossing over thing situation. And I'm looking forward to it because I think, like I said, John Diggle is a badass character. And if you remember at the end of Arrow, in the series finale, John Diggle found something that was glowing green. And a lot of people probably figured it's going to be him becoming the Green Lantern, because there was a whole bunch of fan theories ever since Arrow started that John Diggle was actually Jon Stewart. And it seems like the creators of the Arrowverse wants to make that a reality now that Arrow is over, and you don't have to keep John Diggle in a realistic setting anymore, because Arrow was one of the more realistic looking shows, even though they crossed over with the more fantastical elements once in a while, especially after Flash was introduced. So now that that's over, now it's time to get John Diggle into a more fantastical world, and having him become the Green Lantern is a really cool way. What I'm confused about is because they're saying he's going to be appearing in 5 episodes of all the various shows. That's from what I understood. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it just means he's going to appear in 1 episode each, because there are 5 shows they're saying he's going to be guest starring in. The Flash, Supergirl, Batwoman, Legends, and am I missing one? Oh, Superman and Lois. Those are the 5 shows. The one that they left out was Black Lightning. Black Lightning is now connected to the Arrowverse as well. Crisis on Infinite Earths confirmed that. But for some reason, they're leaving Black Lightning out of it. I know Black Lightning is filmed in a different location, and maybe that's why. But if David Ramsey is guest starring on all these shows, why not just have him pop up in that show also? Especially since it's going to be the last season. I think it would be like, which bothers me even more now, because like, what was the point of integrating Black Lightning into the Arrowverse if you're not going to take advantage of that crossover potential? I don't know. Maybe we can see Jefferson Pierce guest star on the shows afterwards. I don't know. It just seems odd to me. I get it. Like, maybe that's the whole reason that Black Lightning isn't being included this year, because of the pandemic. So, and I know to come to Canada, it's really difficult right now, and I know most of the Arrowverse shows, all the other ones are filmed in Vancouver. Maybe that is the reason, so who knows. But it's kind of sad to see Black Lightning being excluded in all of this. Hopefully, you know, even after his show is canceled, hopefully they still find a way to keep the character in the universe. I wouldn't mind seeing Jefferson Pierce in the crossover still from time to time. So, or maybe even move on to Legends. That would be a cool way to keep him part of the show, part of the franchise, just like they did with Constantine, right? But on to John Diggle, back on topic. It's also being reported that David Ramsey will direct an episode of Supergirl and an episode of Superman and Lois. So I don't know if he's just a big Superman fan and wants to direct both of those shows. But either way, I'm excited to see more David Ramsey, because, yeah, John Diggle is the best. The interesting thing about his Legends of Tomorrow role, though, is that it's being reported that his role on Legends is being described as a mystery role, which is kind of confusing. Unless he's not going to be Green Lantern in the other shows, and that's their way of surprising us when he shows up on Legends. I guess it also depends on what's the order of these shows that he's going to be appearing in. Will he show up in Superman and Lois first? Because he did say he was going to Metropolis and him and his family were going to live in Metropolis. Or is it going to be Legends first to set up whatever this mystery role is, which I think we can all agree that it's Green Lantern. And if it's not Green Lantern, are they going to change his name to John Stewart? I guess that's also another possibility, because why not just make it official that he is John Stewart by just changing his whole name to that? And maybe by the time he gets to the Legends episode, if that one's last, maybe that's the one where he changes his name to John Stewart. Or maybe the Legends go back in time and screw something up in the Arrowverse, and John Diggle is all of a sudden John Stewart. I don't know. I don't know what they could do. I guess the possibilities are endless, so especially if time travel is involved, which Legends deals with a lot. Because let's face it, Barry has already screwed up time enough that I think it's time for the Legends to screw up something for the better. And if changing John Diggle's last name to John Stewart is a mess up, that's probably the best mess up you can do. And I don't think changing his name doesn't have to have an effect on the overall timeline. So I don't know. It would be interesting. So with that being said, guys, tell me your thoughts. Are you excited to see John Diggle return to the Arrowverse like I am? Are you someone that's tired of the Arrowverse and is not even watching anymore? Because I know some people have dropped out. Some people specifically since Arrow ended, some people feel like it's not the same anymore. I still enjoy several of the shows in the Arrowverse, and I'll keep watching all of them. I'm not too sure about the Wonder Girl series that now they're saying is in development, because now I'm starting to feel the fatigue a little bit of it all. But Superman and Lois is totally on my agenda because I love anything Superman. Superman and Batman are my top two favorite superheroes. So you tell me Superman is getting his own series, I'm definitely watching that. Plus, I like Tyler Hoechlin now as that character. Flash is one of the originals, so I'm going to keep on with Flash. Supergirl is ending this season, so I might as well. I was going to stay on with Supergirl because again, one of the originals. Same thing with Legends. Plus, Legends is the most different of them all, so it gets extra points for me for feeling the most different. It doesn't feel similar. Batwoman is the one where I'm feeling like I'm doing my homework because I'm just watching it because it's connected to all the other shows. We'll see how this new Batwoman it works out. Now that they have a new character as Batwoman, maybe it will be a little bit more interesting. But yeah, the Ruby Rose character, Kate Kane, was intriguing to me. We'll see how this one turns out. I'm curious to see how they're working the Bruce Wayne thing. So with that being said, guys, I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to my channel, and until next time, take care.